बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। डियर व्यूअर्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड प्लानिंग एंड टुडे इज द सेकंड पार्ट इज कम्युनिकेशन। सो यू ऑल नो दैट मैनेजमेंट इज टोटली रिलायंट ऑन कम्युनिकेशन, विच हेल्प्स पीपल टू एक्सचेंज आइडियाज, मैसेजेस और इंफॉर्मेशन बाय स्पीच, सिग्नल्स और राइटिंग। सो विदाउट कम्युनिकेशन मैनेजमेंट कैन नॉट फंक्शन। सो नाउ लेट अस सी दैट व्हाट प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सेड एज वी आर डिस गोइंग थ्रू द टॉपिक इस्लामिक मैनेजमेंट। सो वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सेड अबाउट कम्युनिकेशन। So let us first know that we are discussing communication, we are discussing management. So the smile part is important. The smile is very important because in management, in especially when we are communicating, the smile is very important. So before coming to the smile, let us say the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us everything, including manners, etiquettes of communicating with people in meetings, gatherings and elsewhere. If we were to follow the sunnah when communicating with the people, so we would be earning ourselves a great deal of reward inshallah in hereafter. So but thing is that we should avoid unnecessary communication with non-mahrams, especially non-mahrams, you can say, with opposite sex. This should be avoided because in conventional management it happens, and due to business reasons, but it should be avoided as best as possible. So we'll see the one of the best part is smile. So smile, there is a hadith in Jame Tirmizi. It says your smile in the face of your brother is charity. So before you start talking, smile. This is an instant ingredient to start any conversation positively, and it removes any past ill feelings that could be present. Number two, the important thing in communication is pay attention to the tone and volume of others. Beware of tone and the volume of your voice also, and what others are saying, you have to listen to them also. Any undesirable loudness in your voice could put people off and make any further attempts to communicate futile. And there is a verse in Quran, chapter number 31, verse number 19, which says, "And be moderate in your pace and lower your voice. Indeed, the most disagreeable of sounds is the voice of donkeys." So third part we can of communication is start with Islamic greetings, that is assalamu alaikum. And there is also in Sunan Ibn Dawud there is a hadith, a man came to the Prophet and said, "Be peace upon you, assalamu alaikum." He responded to his salutation. He then sat down. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, another man came and said, "Peace and Allah's mercy be upon you." He responded to his salutation when he sat down. He said 20. First one was, he said 10. The second one, he said 20. Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullah, only said. And the third man said, assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Then he said 30. Habituate yourself with saying the full and complete greeting and earn 30 rewards. So say always assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So in the reply one should say wa alaikum salam rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So then number four part is shake hands. That is also an important part of communications. Accompany your greeting with shaking hands if you are greeting your mahram or a person of your gender. Avoid handshaking with your female colleagues also. This happens in multinationals that normally a lot of people they shake hand with non-mahrams. It should be avoided. So one hadith in Sunan Ibn Majah. So there are no two Muslims who meet and shake hands, but they will be forgiven before they part. Before they part their ways. So number five is inquire about people. So this is a psychology, you can say. Ask them how they are doing, and inquire about their health and well-being, and that of their family and friends. They will feel loved and cared for. So next part, sixth part is remember, not all are the same. Consider people's different characteristics and differences while communicating. Keep in mind their age, status, temperament, and other factors also. Because you can discuss with your friends of your same age, you cannot talk the same way with your elders or with children. So number seven is, that's very important. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used teach at every opportunity. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used every chance to enjoin the good and forbid the evil. If there is ever a need for you to say something corrective in nature, so do so gently, very gently. So number eight, refrain from common evils of the tongue. People getting together and communicating with each other leads to falling into various sins related to the tongue, such as talking about Allah without knowledge, slandering, lying, insulting, and cursing. This should be avoided. So a hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari, it says, a slave of Allah may utter a word which pleases Allah without giving it much importance, and because of that Allah will raise him to degrees of reward. A slave of Allah may utter a word carelessly which displeased Allah without thinking of its gravity, and because of that he will be thrown into hellfire. So next is number 9 point is choose simple and concise words. This is very important, and in all the big companies you can see this. These are the good points, and these are the choose simple and concise words, avoid complex language and sophisticated terminologies. So instead, try to stick to concise words and phrases that their eloquence, and seek to understand. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, I have given the superiority over the other prophets in six respects. I have been given words which are concise but comprehensive in meaning. This is from Sahih Muslim. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spoke with clarity and made people comprehend easily, sometimes by even repeating his words thrice. This is the Sunnah. Stay away from arguments, too much of arguments, because being nice is easy when you are dealing with people, but practically speaking, this world has more to it than such people. Despite your best efforts, you are bound to walk into not so nice people. Try not to fall into disputes or unnecessary arguments. In Quran chapter number 8, verse number 46, Allah says, and obey Allah and His Messenger, and do not dispute with one another, lest you lose courage and your strength depart, and be patient. Surely Allah is with those who are as-sabirin. The patient ones are called as-sabirin. If you realize that you are already in a dispute, be wise and argue with that which is better. Allah says in the Quran, and not equal are the good deed and the bad. Repel evil by that which is better. And thereupon, the one whom between you and him enmity will come as though he was a devoted friend. This is in chapter number 41, verse number 34. So we are ending with this topic, communication, now, and inshallah see you soon in another part of principles of management, that is feedback. Jazakallah khair.